the second part of the question. It is difficult. It is very flooded. It seems really that every idea has been done. You know, complicated videos get popular, so you think, let's make a simple one. Simple videos become popular, so let's make a black and white one. And then they're very popular at the moment. So this one's in color.
The train is in the tunnel, Johnny. Yeah. The train's in the tunnel.
Ask John Simmons if he's got a zoom, and if he does, he could zoom into the locomotive portion of the train. Over.
Been stuck in a studio for days on end, definitely. It's great being in the fresh air. It's lovely. A lot of fun. Boys with toys again, you know?
Exactly.
It's great. I love it.
Hey, come back and play.
Come back and play.
Come back and play.
We got all night, all day. Everybody's gonna wait.
Why don't you come back and play?
And play.
Come back and play.
We got all night.
We got all day.
We got all night to play.
You've got an unusual part in this video.
Yes.
Can you tell me exactly what it is?
Well, I'm supposed to be a mystery girl. There's fleeting glimpses of me all the way through the video. So I'm meant to be lying on a tram.
When love breaks up, when the dawn light wakes up,
a new
before we came, I didn't know what we were in for, but yesterday we did some shots yesterday evening and then we got used to the feel of it and it was good fun and got more relaxed.
Now!
I wake up, feel just fine, your face fills my mind. I get religion quick, cause I'm looking to buy. Honey, I'm touching something, you're touching me. I'm under your thumb, under your spell. Can't you see? If I could only reach you, if I could make you smile.
It's just tiring. It's beautiful weather, and it's horrible wearing makeup in beautiful weather like this.
Yeah.
But it's going very well. It's not the kind of thing you do every day.
The idea of doing it on a train?
I think it was Roger, actually, because at one point, I think he was listening to the song, you know, it had this suggestion of like an express train. And then I think Freddie and I came up with the idea of having a train and calling it the Miracle Express. And it just went from there. So we said, you know, they looked into the possibility of doing it and it was possible, so we had a go.
Documentary unit, guess what? You want us to film you filming us?
And the Steadicam, once they make the shot out of the tunnel, is covering the whole guitar solo with dynamic moves on the flatbed.
Does he know that? Are you going with him?
I'm going with him. Then the whole thing moves back again, and camera 2 and 3 are on, Steadicam is off.
Hello. Okay. Hello, 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 hello. Never had a real good friend, not a boy or a girl. No one knows what I've been through. Let my flat on burn. Swore I'd take my mom from the edge of the world. From the edge of the world. From the edge of the world.
After many years on the road, I think it was about 16 or so, we did recording tour, endlessly, I guess. We felt we needed a break, so after our biggest tour ever, which was 3 years ago, ending at Nebworth, where we did all football stadiums, we said, right, we'll take a little break. We're not going to split up, but we just need some space for ourselves. And when the time is right, we'll make the album, rather than, you know, somebody says you've got to make one, so we make one. Mm. So we waited, and we did various other things. You know, Freddie and Roger both did solo projects, and I'm halfway through one, and did a lot of producing. And then we just felt in the mood somehow. And we all had lots of songs, all came in prepared with lots of material. And it seemed like a good time to go into the studio. And we seemed very fresh. As soon as we started playing together again, it felt great. It felt like there was some real magic and real chemistry there, you know. So there's a lot of, on the album, you can hear a lot of first take stuff where we're obviously really enjoying each other's playing. So it had the desired effect. We feel very refreshed and rejuvenated.
What is unusual about this album is that we didn't have any other musicians involved at all. We did everything ourselves, whether it was keyboard parts or we used synthesizers for orchestral parts, some computers for a certain amount of it, as well as live work. But it was all ourselves, which is new in a way, because sometimes on previous albums we've used a keyboard player or had other people in as well. But so that was satisfying in a way, that it was very much Queen, just the four musicians. Oh yeah.
I suppose a very democratic organization, so the ideas come from all four of us separately at different times and in different ways, but there's always a very major sifting process goes on. And we made a very important decision at the beginning of this album, which perhaps we should have made 15 years ago, I don't know, but we said that everything that came out on this album would be credited to the four of us, so it would be written by Queen rather than by Brian, Freddie, Roger or John. And made a huge difference to how we worked in the studio. I think we all felt very, instead of just being possessive about our own stuff, we got possessive about everything. And no one would leave everything alone. No one would leave anything alone. And that's a very, very healthy situation. You know, everybody argues over every note. Mm-hmm. And at the end of it, you have something which I think reflects us as a band much more than we have done in previous times. It also helps after the event, because when you finished your, when you finish your album and it comes down to choosing singles and things, it's hard not to be possessive there. So now we could be completely dispassionate. All the songs were written by all of us, and we can be very very logical about how to put them out and how to treat them, how to do the videos, all the stuff, all the spin-offs. You know.
It's strange about being told that you're an influence on people, because I think every musician is influenced by people, when, especially in the younger days. I mean, I was influenced by Jimi Hendrix and John Lennon and lots of other people. Elvis Presley, every, you know, loads of people. And it's very, always very flattering that the people that tell you that you've influenced other people. And it was brought home to me. I hear there's quite a scene at the moment. It was like a couple of years ago, it's a lot of bands were recreating Led Zeppelin. They were sort of Led Zeppelin alikes. I hear that there's a whole new sort of wave of Queen alikes or something now. I haven't heard any yet, but yes, it's very flattering.
I think particularly in America, there's a whole stream of rock music which has us at one of its roots, you know. Probably us and Aerosmith and I suppose The Who and The Stones and all those sort of things. But Queen is definitely something which is talked about now as a style, which I guess a lot of the new groups feed off. Mm. I think that's a very nice thing, you know, because you know, people start where we left off, and happily we're still in a position to start where we left off. So we feel like we're still out there. There was a major turning point in my life when I went to see Aerosmith not too long ago, I think about 6 months ago, in fact, in the States. And they're old friends of ours, and have very similar background, except they come from a different place. They were slogging around the Midwest America when we were slogging around England and Europe, I guess. Anyway, to cut a long story short, went to see them, and after a long period of not doing very much, they were back on top, and it was great to see. And I talked to Joe Perry afterwards and said, it's great to see that. And at the time, I was very depressed, and I think, you know, most of my life was a problem. And I also thought maybe the group was slipping away. And I said, you know, probably if Queen came to America at this point, we couldn't get arrested, you know. And he said, well, it was the same for us. He said, you know, 3 or 4 years ago, there was no chance. And Joe said 3 or 4 years ago, he had a suitcase and a guitar, and that's about all in the world, you know, after being a big megastar. He said, there comes a time, you know, you reach the bottom, and then there's only a way back up. So Queen, for a long time in the States, certainly became unknown, which is very strange, and it's great to see it beginning to happen there again.
Well, it's gone beautifully, but then we've been blessed with the weather. That really is what it is. We've been lucky, very lucky.
You were shooting yesterday, and you're going to be shooting again tomorrow.
Well, we're just doing some pickup shots tomorrow with Debbie, but this is the end of the train shooting.
So far, you're on schedule.
No, we're about 2 hours late, but it's going very well, and the weather will hold. We'll get a late shoot tonight now.
We just have to keep in mind we will be on this side. So again, like yesterday it was different, it's just that you are aware that he will fly there, but you will feel him and see him, so we can
coming close.
He's not coming too close.
Barry the helicopter, come in helicopter. Got a lovely shot lined up for you here. I'd like to hear from you, over.
Barry.
Yo.
You're the first assistant on this.
Oh, good. Great time for an interview. I love it. Come on.
Has it been a difficult shoot for you?
Laugh a minute. The boys are fantastic. Lots of fun. Cranes, helicopters, you know, the usual kind of... No, really exciting.
The great communications, has that been a problem?
Very, very difficult. But we've got base stations and people relaying messages back and forth up the lines. We're getting through, but it is difficult. But it's great. All
the
chaps are doing wonderful. Wouldn't like to be anywhere else.
When the band told me the first time it was their idea to have it on the train, I said it's brilliant, because the song which we're doing this for, actually you can actually see the train if you know the train idea. But to work it all out was quite a problem. I mean, the thing was we rather preferred to have it done real, on a real train, than the old story of back projection, you know, and it's still in the studio. Obviously, it would have been much more controllable and smooth and easier to do a studio shoot and have just back projections. But on the other hand, if we are able to bring this across, this will look much better.
So, yeah. Okay, now, I've got that, right?
Okay, so...
I've got this walkie-talkie. How do you want to... Do you want to be in the box? Or do you
I'm going to be with you up front here. I'm going to interrupt.
And then we have the queue. We'll have the queue
playing
back
with this. Yes.
All right. Is there anything else I should be holding?
well, we have a spare
okay.
Yeah.
If I could make you smile. Low bridge here, get the camera.
We must have it tight.
We just do it once more.
You baggage.
Just get more than.
One, two.
Oh, I was supposed to wear my bloody shades for that as well.
Everybody on the train who needs to be on the train. If I could only reach you, that would really be. If I could
only reach you, if I could make you smile. We're musicians and entertainers as well. And I think that's something sometimes people don't see, that we actually believe that we're... A lot of what we do is entertainment. We're not terribly ultra serious. We're not terribly, you know, actually into, you know, saving the world at the moment and that sort of thing. But we are entertainment, and that's what people want sometimes. It's if you've been working all day or whatever, you want something that's entertaining, or you know, for the weekend, and you just, you know, it's something to get lost in.
Broad camera. Action. One, two, three, four,
break through. Cut. And cut.
With the smoke, much better.
Steady cam, please. Back in position.
Come on, steady cam. Let's not rest on our
laurels. Steady cam, please. Roll cameras.
Turn over cameras.
Speed.
Oh, you're running?
Beautiful, yeah.
3, 2, 1, action. 1, 2, 3, 4. Break through.
I think it's a very rounded album. I think it's quite mature. It's eclectic, and it's got a lot of hard-ass, great guitar on it. I'd say go out and buy it.
Your smile